back in Power BI, and in today's video, we're going to show you how to use variables when writing your Dax. Variables are something that you'll want to learn, and you'll start to see them as you look at other people's Power BI files. You'll see variables in there. So first off, we're going to show you what a variable is, how to write them, and then how they can help optimize your model and help you with your Dax when you're learning Power BI. It's back to the basics, Dax 101. We're going to show you how to use variables in Power BI. Back in Power BI, in today's video, we are going to show you how to use variables in your Power BI when working with Dax. I will be putting a link to the Excel file in the description below. We're going to start off in a brand new Power BI file, the Maven Analytics Coffee Guide. And first off, we're going to select the coffee shop sales file. Then you are going to open. This is going to bring up Power Query in Power BI. When the navigator opens up, we're going to select transactions, and by hitting the Transform Data button, that will bring the Power Query ribbon open. First thing you always do when you open up a new Power Query is name the query. We're going to call this coffee sales. That is the data. There is no other changes to this query. We're going to close and apply. When you are writing Dax and when you're new to Dax, one of the things you're going to be doing is creating measures. And measures are formulas that help you analyze your data. And when you learn to write Dax, you're going to learn to write these formulas using Dax and using the different expressions. Variables have a way of shortening up and making your models more efficient. We currently have a data table named Coffee Sales. You should always look at your data to make sure that you know what all of the different columns mean, and this will help you write your Dax more efficiently. In this file, we have a revenue column. We also have a product category. We have a transaction date, and we have a transaction ID. Those are the main coffee sales columns that we're going to be using for the variables. You could write, what we want to calculate is revenue per store. Traditionally, what you would do would be to write three different measures and then create a revenue per store. So we're going to show you this. If you wanted to create a new measure, the first thing you would create is a total revenue. And total revenue would be equal to the sum of coffee sales revenue. You would close that out. Now you have a measure called total revenue. The second measure you would create would be the total number of stores. So the total stores equals the distinct count, because there are store IDs for each store. And there's three different stores in this database. So the store ID, a distinct count, would get you the total number of stores. The next measure we would create is we would create the actual measure, which would be average store revenue. Then you would use the measures that you created. So you would divide the numerator. The numerator is total revenue divided by the denominator, which would be total stores. You would close that out. Now we have three different measures. Let's bring those measures into some visualization. So we have total revenue. Now we're going to bring in the total number of stores. And the third measure is average store revenue. Going to make this a little bit smaller. So rather than writing three different measures, you can use variables and create all of this just by writing one measure step by step. So there's actually three steps. You created the total revenue, then you created the total stores, then you created the average store revenue. By using a variable, we're going to create a new measure, and this is going to be revenue per store. And variables start off with by naming the variable. VAR stands for variable. The very first one we're going to do is going to be the revenue amount. So the revenue amount equals the sum of coffee sales revenue. So that was the total revenue calculation you created. The next variable is going to be total stores. And total stores was the calculation, the distinct count of coffee sales store ID. Then you created an additional measure, which was called average store revenue, to divide those two. So when you create variables, you're walking through this step by step. Now we need to return the answer. And the answer is still using the divide function, but we're going to divide, which is still the numerator and the denominator, but the numerator in the variable is revenue amount, and the denominator is stores, total stores. So now we have the numerator and the denominator, and it's going to return that as the answer. So close that out with the parentheses. Now we have our average store revenue was $232.94, and we got that by dividing the total revenue by the total stores, but we had to create three measures to do that. By using a variable, now we just bring in the revenue per store, and it's the same answer as the average store revenue, but we were able to create that with just one measure using two variables and then returning the answer. And now you can still use this revenue per store in other measures, just like you would do some nesting in a regular DAX measure. So let's create one more variable to, again, show you the steps. So let's say if you wanted to create revenue per transactions, and the first thing you would do would be revenue per transactions. You always want to name your measure. And we would create a variable called all revenue. And the formula for all revenue would be the sum of coffee sales revenue. Then we would create a variable, which would be total transactions. So we want to count all the number of transactions. And in this data set, every transaction has an ID. So we want to count using the DAX function count, and we want to count all the coffee sales transaction IDs, because every ID is a unique transaction. Next, we just want to return, and what we want to return is the revenue per transaction, which is the divide function, and we would use the two variables that we created. So we have all rev, then the second denominator would be all transactions, which was the variable that we created. Then you would close that out. And what we're going to do is make this a little bit bigger. So revenue per transaction equals all revenue, which is the variable. And again, you could create all three of these, or you can create this with two variables and a return function, and you can do it in one measure, and you can still reuse that measure. So the revenue per transaction comes up as a measure, and now we could bring in that revenue per transaction into a visual and see that the revenue per transaction is $4.69. That is a look at how convenient and how you can optimize your data models. What variables do, it allows you to walk through the logical steps in calculating your metrics, and then you can put them all into one measure. And by creating these DAX measures, you can still reuse them and nest them inside other formulas. That is a look at variables in Power BI.